Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful, Assalamu alaikum. My name is Hina Naim and today I am presenting crew under the topic Pediatric Infectious Diseases. The first question which arises is, what is croup? Croup or acute laryngeal tracheitis is a viral upper airway infection affects the trachea, the bronchi and the larynx. The swelling results in narrowing of the airway. Inside the trachea, the tissue swells up and causes inflammation and narrowing of airway tract. Here we can see that croup is the upper airway tract infection. This is the healthy airway and this is how the smooth muscles thicken and the pathway becomes narrower. Now another question which comes up is, who are affected by croup? It has an annual prevalence of about 3%, occurs predominantly between 6 months and 3 years of age, primarily during the cold weather months. Males have 1.5 times the prevalence over females. There are two types of croup, namely spasmodic croup and viral croup. Now the causes. Croup is usually caused by a virus. The virus causes swelling of the larynx, trachea, and bronchi, which makes it hard to breathe. Parainfluenza virus and respiratory syncytial virus are the usual viral etiologic agents. Rhinovirus, adenovirus, and mycoplasma can also cause croup. Influenza can cause the most severity. Now, the signs and symptoms of croup. Signs and symptoms of croup are, number one, barking cough, number two, noisy sound when breathing in, number three, fast and labored breathing, number four, fever, number five, runny nose. Now here's a case which I'll discuss in detail. Clinical presentation. YM, a 3-year-old male who attends daycare, developed a cold at the end of the school week. According to his mother, his cold was accompanied by coughing and postcissive emesis of whitish thick phlegm. Overnight on Saturday, his cough, which had become harsher through the day, now sounded like a seal, and he continued to have emesis in an attempt to clear his airway. He did not turn blue, but his mother became concerned when he became inconsolable and seemed not to be able to catch his breath. When brought to the emergency department at his local hospital, he was not toxic appearing, but had audible inspiratory stridor and a barking cough. His temperature was 104 degrees Fahrenheit. His respiratory rate was 38 breaths per minute and shallow. His heart rate was 142 beats per minute. He exhibited perioral cyanosis, retractions, and seemed tired and somewhat listless. His oxygen saturation was 97%, and he was placed on 30% oxygen by mask with nebulized medication, and was able to take sips of fluid after his respiration became deeper and slower, although he still had stridor and harsh coughing. Direct fluorescence antibody test for influenza was negative. Why is this clinical picture consistent with croup? The case will be solved by using SOAP approach. Subjective: cold, coughing, postcissive emesis of whitish thick phlegm, shortness of breath. Objective: barking cough, temperature 104 degree Fahrenheit, respiratory rate 38 breaths per minute, heart rate 142 beats per minute, oxygen saturation 97%, fluorescence antibody test for influenza negative. Here's a question arises. How will you differentiate acute laryngeal tracheitis from spasmodic croup? The answer to this is, it can be differentiated as spasmodic croup is a type of croup that develops quickly, may happen in a child with mild cold. The barking cough usually begins at night and is not accompanied by fever. Spasmodic croup has a tendency to come back. So according to this, the assessment is cough is harsher, continued emesis due to airway obstruction, stridor, diagnosed with spasmodic croup. Now the plan. This child should be treated with a single oral dose of dexamethasone of 0.6 mg per kg and supported with oxygen by mask. An additional dose of racemic epinephrine can be administered for the continued stridor, but consideration should be given to not administering additional doses. If the normal oxygen saturation is maintained, because the already rapid heart rate is likely to increase more with continuous catecholamine use. The dose of racemic epinephrine should be repeated if the stridor or oxygen saturation worsens or cannot be maintained once off oxygen, or if the response to the dose of dexamethasone is lacking after 4 hours of monitoring. Acetaminophen 15 mg per kg should be given for fever and any intercostal or upper airway pain due to vigorous coughing. Another question which arises that how these drugs are working against croup. So first I'm discussing dexamethasone. Edema and inflammation are the main pathophysiological factors in the development of symptoms of croup. Corticosteroids have been increasingly used for the treatment of mild croup. A single dose of 0.6 mg per kg of dexamethasone can hasten the improvement of symptoms. Now, racemic epinephrine. In moderate to severe cases, the patient should be administered nebulized racemic epinephrine 2.25%, which means 0.25 to 0.5 ml diluted with normal saline to a 3 ml volume. The agonist effect can relax bronchial smooth muscle. Doses of racemic epinephrine can be repeated every 2 to 3 hours if needed. Now the patient counseling. Croup is spread in a similar way to the common cold, so it is difficult to prevent. Good hygiene is the main defense against croup, such as regularly washing hands and cleaning surfaces. Try to keep your child calm as symptoms will get worse when child is upset. Encourage child to sit upright. This may make breathing easier. If at any time a child develops feature of worsening or severe croup, the parent should seek immediate medical attention. This includes difficulty breathing, pale or blue-tinged skin, severe coughing spells, drooling or difficulty swallowing, inability to speak or cry due to difficulty taking a breath, a whistling sound with breathing or noisy high-pitched breathing while sitting or resting. This was all about my topic. Thank you.